So hello guys and welcome back to a brand new video. I know I didn't upload for like 4 or 5 days. Sorry for that. I'm gonna upload now. So yeah, I'm uploading today and I might upload tomorrow. Yeah, I should upload tomorrow. So yeah. So thank you. We got 67 subscribers. Let's see if we can get 70. So each time we get like 60 or 70, we go more. Like if you know what I mean. So I'm gonna do a reaction video again, and I'll be doing gaming videos as well. So guys, today Llama Arts just uploaded a new video like 3 days ago. I didn't know why I didn't react to it like before. I should have reacted to it before, but he made a new video. So yeah, and also like this video if you do just like it. And yes, oh yeah, and guys, if you don't know who Llama Arts is, he's a guy who takes what's his name again? Oh, I forgot his name. Mr. Nightmare's videos. He takes his videos, his audio, his voice audio, and he puts it into his videos and he animates them. So he does interesting animations and does it for everyone. So we should subscribe to him. So yeah, I'm subscribed to him. So yeah, that's what he does. And yeah, we're gonna be reacting to that now.
In the year 2009, I was spending a weekend with my uncle on his ranch when my parents were renovating the new house we had just bought. It was my second night there, a Saturday, and it happened to be during one of the biggest thunderstorms of the year. I'd say there were at least 3 crashes of thunder and lightning per minute. And we were in the heart of the storm because the thunder would crash not even a second after the lightning would. I always enjoyed listening to storms while laying in bed. So I stayed up a little later watching TV, just enjoying the ambiance. After the movie I was watching finally ended, I turned off the TV and tried to fall asleep. As I heard the lightning strike from outside, I could have sworn I heard some kind of metallic thud coming from outside at the same time. I didn't pay it too much mind. 20 seconds later, I could have sworn I heard it again. A very distinct metallic thud coming from outside to match the timing of the lightning. I really don't mean to make this sound like a cliche horror story, but my uncle really is a kind of creepy guy, and I was never close with him, even remotely. So for that reason, I didn't feel right going to wake him up. I just tried to forget about it. Now I was getting concerned. What the hell could that be? After the third time, I finally got out of bed and walked over to the window of the guest bedroom. The water pouring down on the window made it extra hard to see what was out there in the dark fields. A flash of lightning momentarily lit up the property, but I couldn't see anything. However, once again, the sound of a metal hit accompanied it. The sound was so close now, it sounded like it was coming from the left of the window at a blind spot. I was going to do something I knew my uncle wouldn't be happy about. It would be a bit messy, but I was going to open the window and peer outside to see if I could see what the sound was.
What? Why? Okay, so if you're gonna open the window, someone might come in and stab you, and then...
I unhooked the window lock and slid it up, and immediately the wind of the storm blew drops of rain into the room and onto me. I stuck my head out the window and looked to the left, and at that very moment, lightning lit up the property once again, and I could see a person dressed in all black crouched down by the outside basement door with his hand raised in the air. And before the sky went dark, I caught the briefest glimpse of what the sound was coming from. The person was bashing at the basement door lock. I pulled my head in and quietly shut the window, making sure to lock it. I was in a panic. I feared he might have seen or heard me. I ran back to bed and pretended to be asleep, facing away from the window. Lightning crashed once again, but this time there was no metallic thud. My heart must have dropped as I realized this. I just stayed put in bed for the longest time, hoping whoever was out there would go away. After maybe 3 more lightning crashes without any thuds accompanying them, I thought it would be safe to go tell my uncle. I turned to face the window and screamed. There was a figure clear as day standing at the window looking in at me. I screamed as loud as I could and ran straight to my uncle's room. He went outside with his hunting rifle with nothing on but his pajamas, not even socks, He ran around the entire property yelling like a madman, but didn't find anyone. The next morning, we were able to better see the marks on the basement door lock. It was almost bashed open. Maybe 3 or 4 more good hits would have done it, according to my uncle. He was proud of me for picking up on it. Luckily, I was out of there that same day. My uncle hasn't told us of any incidents since, so I think he's been okay. Not that we talked to him much at all. I'm grateful I stayed up a little later that night watching that movie, because I may have just stopped a robbery, or possibly much worse.
So guys, that's it, and like, what would you do considering if like someone's trying to break in and you're trying to open the window? What would you do? Would you just open your window and look out? Like, I wouldn't do that because it's just stupid. Imagine if he just comes sprinting at you and punches you, stabs you, and you know, you don't know what could happen. So anyways guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe and like this video. So yeah, this was not really scary, but it was interesting. Yeah, and scary at the same time. So yeah, so I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys later.